Hello guys, Survivor here, welcome to The Raven. Now, I just got done doing that Game of Thrones video, part 2 of the ending of the demo, and I was thinking, since this came for free for gold, I was thinking, what is The Raven all about? I keep hearing it's a great, it had a great story. It's actually called The Raven. Legacy of a Master Thief. And you can totally tell by that tower, it's going to be taking place in London, so. So, yeah. So, I was thinking, why not play this? Because I'm really interested in, games that have, really interesting stories. You know, if they're episodic, you bet your ass they're going to be full stories. And there are three episodes. Three episodes. This whole thing is a trilogy. So, let's go ahead and do this. Because I'm really interested in what's going to happen. Yep. There's downloadable content. Let's check this out. It takes a little bit to load stuff on Xbox. It really does. The music sounds great. Of course, this does take place in London and everything. So it kind of makes sense. Yep, there's episode 3. Creators of The Book of Unwritten Tales. This is full of twists and turns. Wow. Cannot freaking wait. So let's go back. So let's go to the settings. Subtitle, audio. So German and English, huh? Alright. Nice. Subtitles on English, yes. Let me look at the achievements. I'm always interested in the achievements. Save Matt, catch the runaway train, survive the explosion in the red car, finish episode 1, 50 gamer score. That's how much if you beat Bioshock Infinite, barely let's see episode 1. Free yourself from the bonds. This is going to be really interesting. I'm going to look at the extras. Yes, there's just the credits. So yeah. So I hope this is a great game, because I do not want to be trolled by people who think that this is a that say this is a great game, but it's not. So you guys ready for The Raven? I'm sure as hell I am. Let's do this. Oh, chapter 1. So chapter 1 is episode 1, so that kind of makes sense. That train reminds me of Star Swirl Academy. I just played that the other day. It's a fan-made MLP game, but it's pretty interesting and it's pretty cool. Y'all should check out a 2.0 version. It's a lot better than the original demo we got back then. This is fucking weird. But look at this. It looks like we're watching a CGI movie. I'm cutting this shit down, man.
Harold?
Well, shit. is like those kind of movies. This was definitely helped by Pixar.
This is no time for fun and games.
Whoa, what the fuck? What a way to start off an episode. Shit. Shit, man. I did not see this coming. Wow. I bet Pixar helped make this. Because they did Incredibles, Cars, the Tinkerbell movies. They gotta have helped these guys, because I recognize the graphics. I recognize the look. They did. They had to help. Because there's no one else that can do. They can do any look like this. This is pretty damn cool. So when are we getting to the gameplay? Oh shit!
What's your name, boy?
My name is Matthew Miller.
And where are you from, Matthew Miller?
Dillsburg, Pennsylvania. But my mom and I live in England now. She's taking care of some ritual things. We're on our way to Venice at the moment. We're taking troops on a big ship.
I see. You've already seen half the moon. I've spent my entire life in Switzerland.
Must be really boring.
And what's with the gun? What do you need it for?
It's the raven. It's gun down. Now I need it.
Bad birds don't need guns. No, they buy ones.
You don't know who the raven is, do you? He's a French burglar. He stole paintings from the Louvre. And those priceless eggs with gold and diamonds and stuff. And Bobby Dove says he replaced the crown jewels with rhymes.
I know who the raven was. Although, I don't quite buy that thing about the crown jewels. You do know, these days, there are thieves far more dangerous than your old raven. 2 days ago, a precious ruby was stolen from the British Museum. There was an explosion. A guard was severely injured.
Really?
Yeah. And you know what the papers said? You thought
Do I get to?
Inspector LeBlanc.
Shit.
It's a great honor to work with a celebrity like you. We appreciate the support, Swiss police. But would it be better if you remain seated and keep an eye on this?
I would like to help, damn straight. I swear to God, it's like the gameplay and the cutscenes. The cutscenes were made by Pixar. We all know that, because no one would be able to actually do those kind of cutscenes. But these in-game cutscenes, like the gameplay, wow, just holy shit! This reminds me a lot of Star Wars Academy, where there's an anime cutscene. There was just one in that part, but I hope Star Wars Academy has, like, you know, official scenes. Because there's an anime cutscene, and there's the gameplay where you make choices. It's pretty fun. Y'all should go and check it out. It's pretty damn cool.
But, monsieur, surely I can be of assistance somehow. I saw a safe being loaded. We have everything under control. If you'll excuse me, I'll be in the first freight car at the back of the train.
Holy shit.
To enjoy the beautiful scenery. I am a good observer, and I have finally honed powers of perception. Thanks to that, I watch the people on the platform in Zurich. I know, for example, that Batman over there is a violinist. That would be more impressive if there were the violin case next to me. And I believe that the gentleman in the next carriage is a German doctor on his way to Italy to take up a new position. What gives you that idea? There's the rod of Asclepius engraved on his cufflink. And he's carrying a German-Italian dictionary. Maybe he's just taking a holiday in Italy, following in Goethe's footsteps. Too much luggage. And no, he's not retiring to Italy either. The suitcases are too shabby for me to believe that he can afford to retire in his late 50s. All right then, Constable Zell, if you're such a clever fellow, what am I doing on this train?
It's a holiday search for someone. Didn't he just say they were guarding someone before? That doesn't make sense. I'm gonna say he searches for someone like the Raven, because he's on the cover of this game. He's gotta be doing it. He's gotta be helping me out.
I think you're looking for someone. You're just guessing. If I were looking for someone, I wouldn't spend a trip to Double F.
Damn!
Well, that would seem to indicate that you're guarding something. What might it be?
I do not want to go that far. Fuck. I was gonna say money. That's what most people will go for anyway.
We're in Switzerland. The safe was loaded aboard. Perhaps it's full of money. Oh, come now. You really?
Oh shit! I just remembered.
I of all people would be minding a pile of money, and in Switzerland of all places, no. So what is it that I've got?
What I was inside, I had to say, just fuck it.
I really couldn't say. But it must be very important. Why? Because you are very important. They wouldn't have assigned the case to you if it were just a trifle. Let's assume that we really are transporting something very important on this train. And let's assume that it really is my job to see that it arrives safe. Then why isn't the train crawling with police?
More men are unnecessary. That's bullshit. I've seen too many horror movies and everything else that has that. Is a trap? I'm just gonna say it's a trap, because we all know what happens.
It's a trap. You've got a vivid imagination. I'll give you that. Your deductive powers leave much to be desired. I think you'll get it.
You won't. Rose, Garton and Water, I can help. And I will help. You're in my country, and I've been ordered to assist you. And that's exactly what I do, whether you like it or not. Not so bright, but stubborn. Your commitment speaks volumes, Selma. But this is my show, and I don't need it. Well, yeah. But how do you know?
What the hell? Did y'all see his head?
Oh, hello.
You cheated.
I did what?
I saw you talking to the German doctor on the platform. He told you everything himself. You were just pretending to put two and two together.
And what of it? Do you know who that is? That's Inspector Nicholas Legrand. You have to impress him if you want to work with him.
I'm going to tell him you.
You'd really tell him me? To the very policeman who shot your dear Raven?
Whoa! He was here?
Mm-hmm. Hunted and killed Europe's most famous burglar. That's how he got his start.
I won't tell him a thing.
I wouldn't either. All right, Matthew. I have to do my work now.
Everyone calls me Matt. Well, except for my mom. He calls me Matt. As if I were a little kid.
I'm gonna say that kid's like 12.
I help or not, I'll keep my eyes open. Maybe I can change his mind.
Nah, I'm good.
All right.
Wow, this game is cool as heck. What the hell is that? Was that a lag? This reminds me of some Sherlock Holmes stuff, except the new Sherlock Holmes game that just came out. What the hell? Nice. Nice.
Very tough of you. Thanks. Oh, pardon me. No problem. The uniform is waterproof, Mr. Lucia. Professor Edgar Lucia. Oh, a professor?
So far, she is getting pretty interesting.
Do you teach at the Sorbonne?
No, I work at the British Museum in London.
You don't say.
Berkeley is a museum.
So, you were, shall we say, an eyewitness to the burglary 2 days ago.
No, I wouldn't say that.
Oh, no?
There was a lot of commotion, but I didn't really pay much attention to it.
There was a break-in in your museum, and it didn't concern you?
Well, let's just say that nothing that's happened in the last 2,000 years concerns me.
Did anything suspicious, sir?
Did you notice anything unusual on the train?
Here? On the train? No, I can't say that I have, although I did spend most of the time in my compartment.
You know what, guys? Why am I in quiet cutscenes? Most of the time when I do walkthroughs, I'm usually quiet during cutscenes, you know, when people talk and everything, so yeah. Inspector Legrand.
The famous Inspector Legrand is on this train. I imagine you know him. No, should I?
Is he always saying no?
And you also don't know what he's doing?
No. Why should I?
Just a thought. You're a representative of the British Museum. There's a guarded safe on the train.
I'm sorry. I don't know what you're trying to imply. Now, please excuse me.
May I ask where you're going?
Of course. To Venice. I'm going to meet some colleagues there.
Oh, Venice. A beautiful city, so I'm told.
Indeed. But I really have to take my leave.
I don't want to take up any more of your valuable time, but you do understand, don't you?
that what concerns me is the present, and especially the robbery at the museum.
Yeah, of course, of course. It's just, I'm in rather a hurry.
You'll get in touch if you notice anything unusual, won't you, Professor?
Of course, Constable. What's this?
What's the notion?
The door. I can't open it.
We'll sort it out somehow. The compartment is locked.
But I didn't lock it. I don't even have a key.
Oh, shit.
I asked the steward. He was going to bring me one, but he never came back.
Someone would.
Oh, shit.
I'm
someone.
The steward. He needs to bring me the key immediately.
Calm down, Professor. I'll see what I can do.
You don't understand. I have to get back in my compartment.
All right. Just wait here. The little label on the door reads Baroness von Treditz. New blood on the Orient Express.
The gameplay looks pretty cool. It looks exactly like you know, like the cutscene we have with that dude and everything. But some of the cutscenes, this is actually like Star Wars World Academy. I just realized that shit. There are cutscenes that look mostly the same, but there are gonna be cutscenes that are like, you know, cartoonish, like. Like in Star Wars World Academy, there's this one cutscene that looked like an anime, which was fucking sick. It looked really, really great. But most of the time in the cutscenes, there's none. There's like, you know, dialogue and everything and stuff. So that's what this reminds me of. Okay, that's the Vine list, so. Let's go in here. Man, this is pretty damn good so far, man. Man, so it tells you it's gonna be a long ass episode.
I don't believe it.
The fuck?
I never thought I'd ever meet you.
Pardon me, but we've for it. It's all right, Miss Miller. I'd like to speak to the inspector.
Unfortunately, just a constable, Lady Westmacott. I'm reading The Vicarage in the Mirror right now, for the fifth time at least.
That's nice, Constable.
Zellner. Anton Lockhart Zellner.
This is my Zellner. Companion, Miss Miller.
A pleasure. May I ask what you're doing here? Are you on holiday?
Holiday? Yes, so to speak. The first and last holiday of my life.
Madam?
I've been writing since I was a little girl. It became my job, and now I've stopped. So, this must be a holiday.
You quit writing? Impossible. I have all of your books. Your Detective Batu is my favorite character.
Then, I have bad news for you. I threw the old wretch out years ago.
I don't understand.
I'd rather not discuss my work, Constable.
Oh,
fine.
Damn. You know what? Let's ask about that.
As a writer, you must be very observant. Am I right? I mean, you have to study the behavior of people around you to create the characters from the novels, don't you?
I solved the mystery of human nature a long time ago, Mr. Zellner. Since then, most people just bore me.
Really? I had the impression you were eyeing me suspiciously as I came in.
What do you want to know, Constable?
Oh, shit. Oh, man. Oh, God damn it. 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 Guys, I just realized. On my laptop, it says update to Windows 8.1. Oh my god, didn't I fucking do that earlier? Fuck. Now this really starting to piss me off. It really is. Alright, didn't I ask? Oh, where's she traveling to?
Are you traveling to Istanbul, Lady Westcott?
No, we are on our way to Venice. From there, we will take a ship to Cairo. As you may know, I have the penchant for archaeology. I fund a few excavations in Egypt. I traveled to Egypt by ship as a young woman. And now I'm doing it again as an old woman.
I see.
The archaeologist. I think after we talk to her, I'm gonna probably end the video, because I really wanted to do this.
About the other passengers, did you notice the man who just walked into the next carriage with a cup of tea?
I did. He seemed nervous. He was waiting at the bar for the steward, and since the steward never appeared, he elected to help himself. He took two biscuits.
He seems pretty young. But he's already a professor at the British Museum.
Interesting. I'll have to talk to him later. Just out of courtesy, of course.
Of course.
The violinist. I need to know about the violinist, though.
Did you notice the blonde man with the violin case?
I certainly did. He introduced himself and tried to make a good impression. People like him are drawn to wealth and fame, like moths to a flame.
But his charms failed on
me. I know him by name. David Kreutzer. He was a drain on my friend's purse.
Do you think he has a money problem?
People like him always have a money problem. No matter how much you give them, they always spend twice as much and complain that they have far too little.
What the hell is that? Is that just writes on my notebook, Outlast style? I'm gonna guess I did that Outlast style, cause that sounded like the same freaking sound from Outlast. I'm not joking, cause I just remembered that.
Did you notice anyone else?
What about the doctor? I noticed that you were asking about everyone, except for the inspector who went in the direction of the freight car a few minutes ago. Isn't that the Frenchman who made his name when he caught the Raven?
I wouldn't quite say caught.
Well, shot. Why don't you ask me about him and my theory about what he's doing here?
I don't think we should discuss Inspector LeGrand's investigation in public.
LeGrand, right. That was his name. Will he save the day again? Or will you, Constable?
As much as I'd like to keep talking, duty calls.
You were right.
Madam?
I did observe you as you came in. You seem so eager.
It's been a long time since I've had a chance to prove myself, madam.
And this is it. Your chance.
I do hope so.
Then grab it. Even small people can make big changes, as my friend Ronald liked to say.
I shall do my best.
You know what? You know what? That reminded me. She is right. Some small people can actually make big changes. Like, think about like some of the characters from The Walking Dead. They were small, you know, not interesting people, but later on they make big changes and everything else, and wow, like, you know? Like someone actually made big changes and everything. I thought that was sick. In the Walking Dead game, even in the TV show, in the game, and I think the comics, I've only saw videos of some of the issues though. So far, they're actually pretty good. I really like it. What the fuck? What the hell? What the hell? You should be going over that, not under it. What the hell is this? Oh man, I'm being a silly bitch. Okay, I think I'm gonna end the video right here. So yeah, I'm gonna try to make my dude look at the fucking camera. Damn it. Fuck. How hard is it? Fuck. You know what? Fuck this shit. So I hope you guys enjoyed it so far. I think this is pretty gonna be a pretty interesting game. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Like the video if y'all enjoyed, you know, the game. God damn it, my fucking controller. I'm gonna be probably playing Grand Theft Auto or WWE 2K14 or something like that. No idea. But, just ignore this, okay? Just ignore this sign. Because I'm gonna probably... Okay, it didn't fall apart. I had to deal with this in one of the videos. One of the most recent videos. I just can't remember what it was. Okay. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Like the video if you all enjoyed it and think that this game is interesting. And subscribe if y'all want to see more of this or, you know, other walkthroughs I do. Because I'm actually doing Resident Evil the Remake and Nicktoons Battle for Volcano Island right now. And also, I'm also going to be doing the Tales from the Borderlands demo. I think tomorrow, I think. Because I actually got the trial game downloaded, so... I already completed the Game of Thrones one, so y'all can check that out. I just uploaded part 2, so... So, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And again, like the video if y'all enjoyed it, you know, like, think it's interesting and everything. If y'all, like, just like the video if y'all enjoyed it and everything else. Like, if y'all actually liked this video, just like the video if y'all enjoyed it. And subscribe if y'all want to, and again, subscribe if y'all want to see more of, you know, my walkthroughs and everything. Because, and also I do, like, other stuff like reviews and reactions, so, yeah, I also do those. So, but again, subscribe if y'all want to see more. And comment down below about what y'all think so far of this series. Like, do y'all think that I should, like, continue this? Do y'all like it? Do y'all not like it? I just want to know in the comments. Because I like to hear from what people think about my content and everything. You know, everything else, like the game and my content, all that stuff. So, again, hope you guys enjoyed it. And I will see y'all. What the fuck? So I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'll see y'all next time. Survivor.